Then there were these two scientists, Halvet and Leonard. They have constructed a setup, experimental setup, to understand what is going on in this particular phenomenon. Okay, so let us try to see what is that setup. Once you understand the observation made by Halvet and Leonard, you will be like, this chapter is almost over there. Okay, so this experiment is very, very important, right? So first we will draw the experimental setup. You also draw with me. Halvet and Leonard. So I'll draw here. They have set up like this. They have this submarine sort of structure. This is evacuated glass tube. Why this is evacuated? Whatever happens inside this, I don't want it to get influenced by the particles around. So I want it to be perfect vacuum, but that is not possible. So near vacuum, evacuated. This is quartz window. So this is a transparent window through which from a source radiation can be transmitted. Fine. So radiation can travel through the transparent window like this. Getting it? Then you have a photosensitive plate. This is what is a photosensitive plate? A metal, okay, a piece of metal from where the electron can easily come out. Nothing else. It is very sensitive. So if radiation falls on it, the electrons will come out easily. That is why it is called photosensitive. This plate is also called emitter plate. This is emitter. Electrons can get emitted from this plate. Fine. This plate is called collector. This is collector. Is this clear? So if the radiation falls on it, electrons will come out. Fine. So this electron starts to move like this. So there will be several electrons that will then start moving. They will come out, they will have kinetic energy, and they will move towards the collector. Now, if I make this collector a positive potential, what will happen to electron? They'll get attracted. Fine. If I make it negative potential, they'll get repelled. Fine. So I can vary the potential and reverse the potential and see experimentally what all things can change. So I can study the entire behavior. I can not only do that, I can change the intensity of the radiation that is falling on it. Fine. Several things I can change if I have this experimental setup. Fine. So I'll just complete the circuit here. Micro-emitter. Micro-emitter will detect any current it will have. And here you have rheostat. This is the voltmeter. You can change the resistance, and this is a high tension battery, or you can say very high voltage it can go. So you can change the value of potential difference between these two points by changing the rheostat resistance. Getting it? You can not only do that, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. See, suppose you connect 1 and 3, 4 and 8, 2 and 5, and 6 and 7. Then 2 will be at what potential? Positive potential. If you connect these two and these two, 2 will be at the positive potential. And 1 and 3 and 4 and 8, if you connect, there will be negative potential. Fine? But if you connect 2 and 3 and 4 and 7, it will become negative potential. Fine. So using this device is called commutator. Using commutator, you can reverse the polarity. Fine. So you can reverse the polarity and you can change the voltage level also. Is this thing clear? Fine. So what I will do here, suppose there is a, it's like a capacitor plate, you know, this is positive and this is negative initially. I can make it more and more positive, I can make it more and more negative, and I can reverse the potential also. And if I make it more and more positive, electrons will get attracted more and more. Fine. What happens is, when the radiation falls on this surface, not all electrons will have the same kinetic energy. Fine. Some electron will be able to reach till here. Some electron will just die down. Their velocity will become so less that they can get again attracted back towards the emitter. Fine. But if you have a positive potential, then there is a pulling force for the electron to come towards. Fine. But at any moment, suppose 10 electrons are ejected from here. How many can catch max? 10 only. So this positive charge will not be able to increase number of electrons that are coming out from here. But it can increase number of electrons it catches. Getting it? Fine. So we have what all parameters to play with? We have, write down, intensity of radiation. That we can vary and see what will happen. We have potential difference to check. We have current to check. Then what? We have frequency. Fine. So these are the four factors we will see in this particular experiment. Fine. Now, why this is detecting a current micro emitter? This is an open circuit from here to here. But electrons from here, if it manages to reach here, then the circuit is closed. Fine. So this micrometer will detect a current only when electron from the collector, sorry, electron from the emitter is caught by the collector. Fine. So if there is zero current, means electrons are not able to reach the collector. Fine. Right. So there will be a potential. There will be a potential in which this is negative potential and this will be positive potential. If you make this negative potential high enough, current will stop. It will ripple all the electrons. Getting it? Initially, energy of electron will be so high that small negative potential will not be able to deter them. Electron will be still able to reach there. But if you make it very high, electrons will be stopped. And that is called the stopping potential. Fine. What you have to do that? You have to make sure that electron which has the maximum kinetic energy, that is not able to reach there. If you are able to stop the maximum kinetic energy, others will automatically stop. Okay. Let's see now. Few of the observation we'll see. Write down variation of current with intensity. You're changing the intensity and seeing how the current is changing. Suppose this is photocurrent. What is a photocurrent? Electrons that are coming out from here, the current due to that is called photocurrent. Microemitter detects a photocurrent over here. And this is intensity. Okay. What is seen is straight line. In fact, this is not so straight. Fine. So what does it say? What does it mean?
Directly proportional.
Directly proportional. It is directly proportional. So if intensity is not changed, photocurrent will not change. Fine. No matter what you do, if the intensity is same, photocurrent will be same. Okay. There is a direct correlation between photocurrent and the intensity of the radiation. Fine. Next, what we are going to do here is variation of photocurrent with potential. Fine. On the y-axis, again there is a photocurrent. And this is potential. Can you guess what kind of graph it will be? You're changing the potential, right? You are assume that if it is positive, it means positive potential. If it changes the polarity, it's negative potential. Try to see. I mean, try to draw yourself what is the graph. Thank you. So if you increase the potential to very high, what will happen to current? If current is very high, sorry, voltage is very high, it will catch all the electrons that are coming out from here. Okay? So but then after some time, no matter what is the potential, current will be same. Okay? So current will be uniform for very high voltage, but if you decrease the voltage, current will dip little bit. Why? Because not all electrons will be able to reach the collector. Fine? And if you further decrease the voltage, you make it negative, then the current will stop at a particular potential, which is called the stopping potential, V0. Fine. This is, let us say, intensity I1. Okay. Now if you change the intensity, if you change the intensity to I2, where I2 is more than I1, what do you think will happen? It will go up, current, saturation current will be more. And one weird thing will happen is the stopping potential will be same. Current is of course increased because the intensity has been increased. Right? This current is called saturation current. Saturation current for I1, and this is saturation current for I2. Okay. This much and this much. Okay. Now one weird thing is the stopping potential is same no matter what is the intensity. Right? What you are doing is you are maintaining the frequency. Frequency is same. You are not changing the frequency when you're changing the intensity. Okay, what does it mean if the stopping potential is same? What does it mean? The maximum kinetic energy that comes out from here is, let us say, K max, and if stopping potential is V naught, how these two are related, K max and stopping potential? You know, right? Conservation of energy, K1 plus U1, kinetic energy plus potential energy, is equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy. And K1 minus K2, you can write it as U2 minus U1. So change in potential energy is what? Charge into potential difference, E times V0. K1 is K max, K2 is what? Zero, it stops. So K max should be E times V naught. Fine. So this observation says that the maximum kinetic energy of the electron that comes out from here does not depend on intensity. No matter what intensity of radiation you fall on the metal surface, the maximum kinetic energy of the electron will be same. Okay. This is actually slightly weird, but then the other observations are, you know, a little bit more insightful. Like for example, next one is variation of current with V0 only, but now you're not changing intensity, you're changing frequency. Okay, just draw this. This is potential. This is photocurrent. So for a particular frequency and intensity, the graph is like this. Okay, let us say this is for frequency mu1. Right? Now I am keeping intensity same. Intensity I am not changing, but I am changing frequency now. What do you think the graph will be? Will the saturation current be different? saturation current be same or not?
Yes.
It will be same because intensity is directly proportional to photo current. Fine. So saturation current will be same. So the graph will start like this only, but slowly and slowly it will deviate, and now the stopping potential is different. Stopping potential for two frequencies are different. This is for mu1 and that is for mu2, where mu2 is greater than mu1. Okay. Fine. This is again a weird finding that the, what does this mean? Maximum kinetic energy does not depend on intensity, but it depends on frequency. Fine. But total number of electrons that are coming out are same, just that they have more energy now if you change the frequency. Fine. The final graph is stopping potential versus frequency. Stopping potential is what? A potential at which? Potential at which the current stops. So this is V0 and this is mu. It is found to be a straight line like this. This is for metal 1 and for metal 2 you get a parallel line. This is for metal 2. Okay. Sorry, on y-axis there is stopping potential. And x-axis mu. Now this is the most weird observation of all. Here you can see that the stopping potential is increasing with frequency. That is, we have already observed that if you increase the frequency, stopping potential increases. So this is all right, that stopping potential is increasing with the frequency. It is like this. But one thing that is weird is this point is zero potential is required to stop. What does it mean? No electrons are coming. Fine. So from here to here, this is a range of frequency and this point is called threshold frequency for metal 1 and this is the threshold frequency for metal 2. So it says that if your frequency is less than the threshold frequency, what will happen? Electrons won't be able to come out. No matter what is your intensity. It doesn't matter what is the intensity, electrons will not be coming out. If frequency is less than the threshold frequency. Okay, this is very very weird because imagine the situation that frequency is very less. Okay, you are supplying energy to the electron with a very less frequency radiation. Fine. So if the frequency is less and electron is getting less energy, it can wait for few milliseconds or few seconds to acquire sufficient energy and then should come out. But it is not doing that. Even if you put the radiation for hours and hours with a frequency less than the threshold frequency, then also it will never come out. Okay? And if your frequency is greater than the threshold frequency, even if intensity is very very less, then also electrons will come out. This is actually weird. Hence, using wave theory, you will not be able to understand what is going on. As in, if it is a wave, the electron should absorb sufficient energy from the wave, wait for some time, and then come out, even if frequency is less than threshold frequency. But that is not happening. Fine. So to understand this, Einstein has given a particle behavior of light theory. And that particle, Einstein used to call it photons. Okay, so this is like the observation that has led to that theory.